Good morning, students. Welcome to the Social Science online class. Today, we are going to see Term 2, Unit 1, Geography, Resources. First, we'll see what is resources. Students, do you know what is resources? We'll see anything which can be used for satisfying the human needs is known as resources. So, resources maybe it can be water, oil, soil, minerals, animals, plants, wind, anything. So, anything that is satisfying the human needs, that is called resources. If you are thirsty, you want to drink water, right? So water, it's a resources. You need that. Then if you drink, you satisfy. That is the resources. And for the things, if you want to build a house, you want a soil. So that is the resources. And another thing. So if you want to grow something, if you want to grow organic things, organic plants. So you want that seed and everything, that all resources. Okay, we'll see the introduction. A country's social, economic and political strength lies in the distribution, utilization and conservation of its resources. So, country economic level and the political strength, it's based on resources only. Because if it is country means need lot of factories for the economic growth, lot of development things needed, right? For basic, if you want to run a business means you want inputs. That inputs called resources. For example, if you want to start a textile means you want that clothes. For the cloth, you want the that jute. Whatever, jute or cotton, anything that is resources. For the production level, next resource you need. So, once you give the input only, you can get the production and the goods and you can service. You can sell it and you can earn the amount, right? So, the country economic level is going up. So, for the resource distribution and utilization, conservation, it's everything for the country economic level, it's based on resources only. Okay. So, normally natural resources are classified into two. Okay, basic, that is basic of origin and another one is basis of renewability. Before that, what is natural resources? Naturally, we got the resources. That is called natural. So, natural resources are resources that exist without action of human hand. So, that are naturally will get it. Okay, natural resources are obtained from environment. So, environment, we can get that. So, many natural resources are essentials for human. For example, water, air and everything. So, a lot of things are there. Naturally, we get, right? Easily, we get land. So, that are natural resources. So, that is classified into basis of origin and basis of renewability. So, basis of origin have further classification. That is biotic and abiotic. Biotic and abiotic. Okay. And basis of renewability that was classified into two, renewable and non-renewable. Okay, so we'll see one by one definitions. First one is biotic. What is biotic resources? Biotic resources are found in the biosphere which are obtained from living and organic materials. So, biotic resources are natural resources we have already seen because that is a classification of natural resources, right? So, biotic means we can get the organic materials. So, from living and organic materials. that was getting from the living organic materials. For example, fossil fuels like coal and natural gas and petroleum. These are living and organic materials. That was called biotic resources. Okay, what is biotic resources? Biotic resources are found in the biosphere, which are obtained from living and organic materials. Okay, organic means raw materials. Okay, so next, what is abiotic resources? Abiotic resources are the non-living parts of an environment. Non-living parts. Non-living means sunlight, there is no living, and water, for example land, that all are non-living parts of an environment, right? For the example of abiotic resources, land, water, air, sunlight, gold, silver, copper, etc. These are will getting from non-living parts of an environment, that is called abiotic resources. So, abiotic resources are the non-living parts of an environment. Okay. Next, we'll see what is renewable resources. So, in that name, we can get the idea that resources are, we can get again and again. That all are renewable. We can get more. We can get easily. That was renewable. Okay. So, a renewable resources is a resource which can be used repeatedly and replaced naturally. So, replaced naturally, we can get repeatedly. Replace, for example, for the sunlight, day to day we can get it. So, there is no limit. If for the sunlight, is there any limit is there? No, naturally we can get. So, that is a renewable one. That is a replaceable one. And for example, well, you can see this picture. This is waterfall, right? So it is normally comes. It is replaceable and also that is renewable. Okay. So renewable resources harvested and used rationally will not produce pollution. So for the natural renewable resources, that will not make pollutions. That's all very natural. There is no pollution. That is very good. Okay. What does renewable resources? Yeah, renewable resources is a resource which can be used repeatedly and replaced naturally. Okay. Next, we'll see the solar energy. That is a renewable resources. We'll see what is solar energy. We'll get the energy from sunlight. So that is called solar energy. Okay, solar energy is power of heat that comes from the sun. So power or heat, we can get sunlight power. Okay, sunlight energy. Okay, solar energy is power or heat that comes from the sun. So look at the picture, students. Solar energy used captured sunlight to create photovoltaic power, PV, okay, or concentrated solar power. So what is photovoltaic power? So look at the picture here in the blue white dots are there, right? These are called the electronic power consumers. Okay, that chip that take from the energy from sunlight, take the energy from the sunlight and store it. Okay, that is create the photovoltaic power, that is electric energy. Okay, that is called photovoltaic power or concentrated solar power. Okay, for the solar heating. Okay, that is called PV or CSP. So India, China, Japan, Italy and states of America are major utilizer of solar energy in the world. So these countries are used majorly for the major utilizers, okay, of solar energy in the world. Do you know, students, in our Tamil Nadu, Ramanadur district, Kamuthi Solar Power Project. So this is the one of the largest solar power project in the world. okay, that was in our Tamil Nadu, okay. So the Kamuthi solar project was completed on 21st September 2016. Investment of this project is around 4,550 crores, okay. The installed capacity of this project is 648 megawatts, okay. So that's all about the today class, students. Thank you.